The Fundamental Theorem of Arithmetic. The Fundamental Theorem of Arithmetic states that any given integer n greater than 1 can be written as a product of prime powers. Let's take an example. 12. The integer 12 can be written as 2 square into 3. We can see it is a product of prime powers. Then, how do we use the Fundamental Theorem of Arithmetic to find the GCD and LCM of any given number of integers? Let's take an example. What if we are asked to find the GCD and LCM of 26, 48 and 36? The first thing what we do is, we will write 26 as a product of prime powers, 2 into 13. We'll write 48 as a product of prime powers, 2 to the power 4 into 3. And we'll write 36 as 2 square into 3 square. Now, to find the GCD and LCM, we need that each prime should be present in every integer. In the first integer 26, 3 was not present, so we multiply by 3 to the power 0. In the second integer 48, 13 was not present, and in 36 also 13 was not present. So we multiply both these in products by 13 to the power 0. Next, to find the GCD, we will take the product of all the primes with the smallest power. So if we can see that 2 has the smallest power 1 and 3 has the smallest power 0. 13 has the smallest power 0. Multiply them, we will get the GCD is 2. How do we then find the LCM of 3 integers 26, 48 and 36? We already have all the 3 integers written as product of primes. What we do is, we will write all our prime base 2, 3 and 13 and take the largest power of each prime. 2 has the largest power 4, so we write 2 to the power 4. We multiply by 3, take the highest power of 3, which is 2, and multiply by 13, take the highest power of 13, which is 1. Multiply all the 3, we will get the product as 1872. So this is how LCM and GCD is found. We can extend this to 4 numbers. What if to these given numbers we add one more integer? And now we have 28, 26, 48 and 36. All of them have been written as product of primes, and we can see the primes present in all of them are 2, 7, 3 and 13. They were present in some integers. They were not present in the others. So we have multiplied by raising them to the power 0. GCD of these 4 numbers we can see is 2 to the power 1. We've taken the smallest power of 2. We have multiplied by 3, raised it to the smallest power of 3, which is 0. 7 raised to 0, multiplied by 13, raised to 0. The GCD is 2. And for LCM, we take the largest power of each prime and multiply. This gives us the LCM as 13104.